Tariq.
Oh my gosh.
You have been caught. What is going on over here?
Not you again. Oh my gosh. You can't leave me alone for one day.
No, there's no way. You gathering wood for?
I'm, you know, just about to start a fire, you know, right. Out here in the country, in nature and everything. Nothing special, you know. I've just been out here in Yurt Village.
In Yurt Village, is that what it's called?
This is Yurt Village. What? You've never been here?
No.
Let me show you a little bit. This out here is a little bonfire. We can hang clothes over here. Not much clothes being hanged. We go to the laundromat still. We're not that country. But if you want some warmth, you know, I'm just about to make some fire. My peeps are about to come up the hill. Follow me. You know? Just gonna set this here, but you know, I just moved into my new place.
Oh, can we see that new place?
You wanna see my new place?
I would love to see your new place. What is it like?
You can see my new place. So, this is Yurt Village. My yurt is round yonder. Follow me. Isn't it beautiful? Nature, birds. So, this is my yurt, okay? I don't have a name for her. I should name her right now. What's her name? Bertha. I like Bertha. She's blue. Anyways, this is my yurt, okay? I am enjoying nature. I'm enjoying it out here. I'm about to bring you in. Just know I did not clean because look, I'm in the woods. Why are you expecting this to be like sparkling clean? Look, it's wood. There's no heat, like little electricity. You're gonna get the real, okay? So I did not prepare it. It's just is how it is and how it always is because I'm barely in this yurt. I only sleep in it and then go about my day. So come on in. Ooh, okay. So it's not much light, as you can see. Does the light look good on the camera?
It actually looks good.
Okay, good. But yes, that is the only light we really have in here is the Christmas lights around the top. And this is specific to my yurt and the yurts in Yurt Village. There are some yurts that do not have Christmas lights or lights at all in the mountains, the mountain yurts. It's crazy how like elitism made its way into nature. Like how down here in the Yurt Village we got electricity and lights and the people in the mountains don't got what? Nothing.
All right.
But anyway, it's so sad. Even in nature, there's oppression. But yes, okay, so I have the biggest shirt. Don't ask me how I have the biggest shirt. It came with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It came with 6 twin beds. So this right here is my queen size bed. It's 2 twins made into 1. As you can see, I just put them together and you know, you just kind of close the gap. But yeah, this came with the yurt on the farm. They just gave us all these twin beds. But because of Corona and because of like privacy reasons, everybody is 1 person per yurt. But you know, you can sleep with other people if you want to, but they just wanted to make sure that everybody had their own yurt so people didn't feel, you know, piled up on each other. So yes, I had 6 beds. So 2 of them went to this one right here. We got 1 bed and it's really cozy. You know, I like to stretch out and yeah, we don't have heat in the yurt, by the way. So these 2 blankets are kind of for like comfort to lay on. And then you have all these extra blankets to really pile on right here, like a lot of blankets. Just blankets and blankets and blankets and blankets because we are in Vermont. And if you do not know how North Vermont is, I'm gonna put a map up here so you know how north it is. It gets ridiculously cold during the nighttime in Vermont. And what month is it? September, October, low 30s. We're back in the 30s this week.
Ooh.
Yeah.
So no.
It's gonna be really cold this week.
Oh, hell.
Yeah. So it gets really cold. So that's the bed situation. This is actually not a bed of, what's it called? A headboard? This is not a headboard. This is actually one of the beds that's supposed to go under one of these mattresses over here that I'll show you. But we kind of flipped the headboard sideways so it looks like a headboard, so it looks more modern. But this is not a headboard, we made that shit up. And these candles are not real, these are electric, you know. Somebody on Twitter laughed at me because I said I put candles by my bed one night when it was like 32 degrees so that I could get a hint of heat. It's all mental, all in the head. You're warm if you think you're warm, you know what I mean? And this candle, I look at it and I say, ooh, fire, even though there's no fire. So that's good for your mental health and all of that. What else do we have? Over here, this is actually one of the beds that one of the mattresses are supposed to go on. We just flipped it vertical and I made it into a little shelf. So I have my jeans here, shirts, pants and all of that. And then I have my shoes down here. I didn't really bring many shoes. Listen, I'm on a farm, I'm in nature. I'm not meant to look cute, even though, even though I do kind of look cute here and there, you know, I got to stunt on the foxes and the coyotes and the goats. You know what I mean? Like, they got to know that even though we in nature, I'm still that bitch. You know what I mean? So, like, don't play with me. So, you know, I have to bring out, you know, the fashions. This is what we call nature couture. You know, cottage boy, cottage core culture, all of that. Anyways, this came with the yurt as well. This is a little shelf. It's like a bookshelf, but I made it into, I had a lot of clothes. I have a lot of clothes over here and some random other stuff over there. And then over here, we're back to luxury, my Telfar bag. You know, I didn't want to bring all the other luxuries in the nature, you know. You know, black bears are really common in Vermont, and I didn't want somebody to snatch my bags. So I just bought one, you know what I mean? And these are the hand warmers. These help you stay really warm at night. What I do is I take out the hand warmers and I sometimes put them inside my shirt. Like I said, it gets to like 30 degrees at night sometimes. And I put it inside my shirt or I put it under my pillowcase so it's like warm on my ears and on my face. I think everybody has different like cold spots on their bodies that if that place is cold, the rest of your body is cold. And for me, it's my ears and my feet. Like my feet have to be lotioned and warm. Like if my feet are ashy, I cannot go to sleep. Like I'm so serious. Like I will really get up just to put lotion on my feet. I can't sleep with ashy feet. Cause it's just uncomfortable. Here's my luggage, nothing fancy. And over here, this is my cute little bedroom couch. As you can see, these are two mattresses stacked on top of each other. And as the for the headboard is another mattress. So it looks like a little cute couch. You know, so when you come over and I'm having people over and I'm just talking to them, you know, it's like, oh my gosh, I love your couch. Where'd you get it? I'm like, Article, you know, like, what's that other place? West Elm.
Oh.
I got this from West Elm.
Yeah.
Yes, this is a couch from West Elm, but I don't really use it as a couch that much because, to be honest, not many people come in my yurt. We're usually outside at the bonfire. It's too cold to be chilling in here at night. So if we're not in here at night, during the day we're in the barn. So at night we're usually around the bonfire where it's warm. So that's why there's so much clothes on here because I needed more place to put my clothes. So it's a couch, but it's also like a closet, you know, like everything in life. Over here is a little another table. This is like my tech stuff, like my camera bag, some bug spray, some ibuprofen because I was dealing with gingivitis a couple of weeks ago. Yes, I brushed my teeth. I just haven't been to my dentist in a long time and she needed to get some plaque off of my teeth. And so I had to do it in New York while I was, okay, it's a lot. But yes, I got a big bottle of ibuprofen. Don't think I'm addicted to the painkillers. I just needed my pain to be killed in that moment. So yeah, deodorant. Need a lot of deodorant, okay? We are in the woods. Okay, just to get up to the Yurt Village, you gotta go up that long mountain like I showed you guys in my last video, and you need deodorant. So yes, that's my little yurt. She's really nice. She's an experience, I will say. Oh, electricity. We have this light here. It don't really do that much. I mean, it don't really do that much. But you also have the light up there, if you show them, Aaron. That light to the top. And the outlets, you only have two right here. And they have some USB ports, so that's where, there's somebody knocking. Oh, that was me. I literally knocked.
Literally you did.
I literally knocked and asked who was knocking. Oh, wow. Okay. So yeah, there's two outlets, so I try to reach it to my bed, but it don't even matter if my phone don't even reach to my bed because I don't get any service or reception up here. Like, I can't get text messages, I can't send text messages, I can't get on Twitter. And I'm not just talking about iMessages. I can't even do MMS up here, like, so it's a good disconnect. I kind of like that because, you know, I could talk to myself, talk to my yurt village, talk to my people. Speaking of, let me go get this fire ready for my people. I'm so happy you liked my yurt. What did you think of it?
I mean, this was quite a beautiful luxury yurt.
Absolutely.
You made it work for you.
Absolutely. Who needs to be in LA? But yes, here's my porch. Oh my gosh, look at my porch, you know. It rained, so I'm not gonna sit because I'm already wet enough.
Hey.
LOL. But yeah, this is our little porch, and I wake up every day breathing the air. Appreciate that I am alive. I am black. I am beautiful. I am fearless. I am fierce. I'm a black boy out here enjoying my life, indulging in my dreams and my passions and my talents, and I want that for all of my black people and all of my people. Everybody that watches, I want everybody that watches to take time to recenter yourself, appreciate yourself and your talent. And yeah, just live. So yeah, that's my little yurt. This is Yurt Village. But today I had to record my yurt tour because I am being evicted. So I am being evicted because we just, so the project that we're doing here that I shared with you in the last video, they're documenting the whole thing for a documentary, and they got a new videographer. New videographer that is coming is staying in my yurt and needs my yurt. So I'm being evicted. Sounds like racism and homophobia to me, but you know, you gotta do what you gotta do for the cause. So I had to film my yurt tour today. So that is why Yurt Village is silent. Everyone is in the barn. But thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys loved it. My name is Tariq Ali. Please subscribe, like, and comment. I don't really know what else you're supposed to get out of this video. You just saw my yurt and that was it, but I love you. I love all my Tabies. Have a great day. Look at me. It's the yurt for me. It's the yurt for me. I look so cute in nature. Oof. Oof. Bitch, I'm living in the woods looking this good. It's a simple life for me. Absolutely. It's the barn for me. Yes. I'm having a great time, y'all. It's going to be a beautiful day, a very productive day, a day full of high spirits, happiness.